MMA Weekly, Damon Martin here with Rich Franklin in Cincinnati, Ohio. Rich, how's everything going?
Going real well, man. I'm putting the final touches on the camp. We're 3 weeks out today, and feeling really good. So we're getting ready to get started today, and feeling good about this fight, man.
Now, you stayed in Cincinnati for this one. I know you've been traveling to Matt Hume's camp up in Seattle. What was the reason for staying home this time?
Just, you know, I had gone up to Matt's camp, to his gym prior to actually starting my 8-week camp for this. And I've been up there a couple times, and he's, you know, he's done some stuff with me. But, I was training here before I started the 8 weeks, and I just kind of got into a good groove with things, and I really didn't want to switch stuff up. So I kind of left things the way they were. I have great training partners going on here right now. It's just I feel really good about the way that the camp is going.
Yeah. I know you've had some time off between fights, and I know there was rumors about a couple other fights that you may have been in. Can you give us a background on, you know, why the time off? And obviously with that, I mean, how does your body feel after finally getting a little bit of a break?
Feels good, man. You know, I'll tell you what, I needed some time off both just kind of mentally to reset and physically to reset. I didn't have any major injuries. I did have my umbilical hernia surgery that I had done, but other than that, I mean, most of the stuff that I was doing was just you know, little bumps and bruises and things like that here and there. But I'll tell you what, having some time off really made me appreciate training again and all that kind of stuff. So mentally just been in a really good place for this whole camp.
Everybody knows you've been kind of bouncing back and forth with weight classes. You did the catchweight with Vitor, obviously been fighting at 205. This fight with Chuck is at 205. So how is your body feeling, and do you feel like 205 is really going to be the place where you need to be right now?
We'll see. You know, I think, I mean, really I've only had one true fight at 205. I had Hamill at 205. Henderson was a 205-pound fight, but he's not a big 205-er anyway. And then I had two catchweight fights at 95, and so now I'm back at 205 again. So we're going to see how this goes. But I'll tell you what, I feel great. I feel great not having to cut the weight. I'm back down to 185. I feel much better in the cage and all that kind of stuff. So I think that this is the place for me.
Give us your thoughts on Chuck Liddell, of course. We know that you got brought in to fight Chuck after Tito had to drop out for whatever reason. What was it that intrigued you the most about Chuck? And, I mean, was it just a matter of the timing being right for you to accept that fight, or what was it?
You know, I never really thought I mean, looking back, I never envisioned myself ever fighting Chuck in my career. And Tito got hurt for this fight, the way it was explained to me. And Dana called me and said, look, we need a replacement for the fight with Chuck. Are you willing to step in and do this? And I had some downtime, and I said, my answer to him was, have you checked with Chuck's camp to make sure that they're cool with it? Because Chuck and I know Chuck would sit next to each other at UFCs and stuff like that. I would consider him a friend. And so he said, yeah, I've checked with Chuck. They're okay with it. You know, business is business. And I said, okay, then let's do it.
Does it change the dynamic at all, knowing Chuck as long as you have, anything like that? Or is it just kind of take some of the pressure off that there's no animosity or any of that stuff?
You know, really, I'm one of those people in my career who've never had any kind of animosity towards anybody that I've fought. You know, you see like the hype between Quentin and Rashad fight that's about to come up, and those guys truly just don't like each other. And I've just never been in that kind of situation with one of my opponents. And I fought Hamill, of course, and he and I are friends. We'd actually trained together. We're both from the Cincinnati area. So, you know, this is just something. It's, like Dana said, like Chuck said, business is business. So we'll have our 15 minutes of scheduled time, and I'm sure he and I might hang out for a few minutes after the fight or something.
When you fight a guy like Chuck, who is obviously a striker predominantly, that's pretty much what he always does it change your game plan without going into strategy too much? Does it allow you to mix things up a little bit, knowing, you know, predominantly he's going to want to keep it on the feet?
You know, yes and no, because I wouldn't be surprised if Chuck shot a few takedowns in this fight. I mean, he did against Vanderlei, and he did against Shogun, and so it wouldn't surprise me to see this fight not be the typical kind of fight that the kind of performance that Chuck may put on. So, you know, I would expect that he would, but I'm kind of prepared for a little bit of everything, and I wouldn't go into a fight making an assumption like that.
I know you're expecting the absolute best Chuck Liddell we've ever seen, but there's a lot of talk about his retirement and, you know, the performances he's had lately. What are your thoughts on Chuck's performances? Was he just getting caught? I mean, did you see weaknesses in his game, or what are your thoughts on that?
Typically, that kind of stuff comes down to a lack of focus, and I don't know if that was Chuck's case or not. I don't know. I wouldn't want to sit here and presume that I know what's going on through in his head or in his training camps or anything like that. I do know that when I saw Chuck recently, he looked to be in the best shape I'd ever seen him in, ever. So I do assume that I'm going to get the best Chuck possible.
because of the time off and because, you know, you've actually had a full training camp for this one and obviously time to prepare, do you feel like this is the best Rich Franklin we could see right now at this time as opposed to 3-4 months ago?
No, I think so. I think this is definitely a better Rich Franklin than you would have seen 3 or 4 months ago. And I'm willing to put that on the line in Vancouver.
This is a big marquee fight in the division. If you win this one, title hopes still, I assume?
Neither myself nor Chuck is considered probably, definitely not top five, maybe not even top 10 fighters in the UFC right now. I'm not sure. I don't even pay attention to the rankings. So I don't think a win over Chuck would necessarily put me in title contention, and I'm not about that kind of stuff. I would imagine that I still have some leg work to do in the 205-pound class. And that's something that I'm definitely interested in.
And I just want to give you a chance, your fans, the people in Cincinnati, everybody's been so supportive. What did you want to say to your fans?
Man, you always get put on the spot with this stuff, man. I'll tell you what, I've had a beautiful career and I've had great fan support everywhere I've gone. Everywhere in the United States and everywhere in Canada. So thanks for the support. It's going to be interesting because Chuck's got a big fan base too. So I wonder what the reception is going to be like for each of us when we get to Vancouver.
I'm a little disappointed, no black eye yet.
Not yet. I still got 3 weeks, and that's usually happens sometime between now and the fight.
Thanks, Rich.
Welcome.